Oh, I need my hat. Are we recording? Are we recording? Babe, my hat.
Oh, yeah, we live.
Testing one penis tube.
Welcome to Slidecast.
What's up? We've got Christian today. He's actually the true, like, third member of Slideways Garage, but he's always freaking busy.
All the time.
We finally got him at a free moment.
Or behind the scenes.
Yep. He's like the guy that works on everything when no one's really looking.
Yeah.
All right. So, ready to go over the last event?
Stroud. Last event was chaotic and good at the same time. We had multiple problems with the car.
They started off tuning.
Yep. We had to tune the car. Brandon was doing some data logging while we were doing pulls on the back strip. And it started to look good, so we decided to go take it on track. But then it started cutting out, and we couldn't figure out why.
So what happened when you found out?
Found out that the fuel cell I had, the foam inside of it, was not E85 rated.
So what'd you do, Christian?
I fixed that shit.
How'd you fix it? What happened? What'd you have to do?
Well, we took it apart, dumped a shit ton of gas everywhere. Luckily,
a whole 8 gallons.
Yeah, luckily we found a tank to actually catch some of it. Took apart the fuel filter, seen all the mesh and everything. Just 85 is just not good with that mesh, unfortunately, that we're running. So it's going to need something, though, because I don't know if it ever did or if it will. But it's going to slosh, and that could end up being a problem of us running lean.
It was starting to slosh at the end of the event just because we were running low on fuel, but it wasn't like a big, big problem.
But other than that, the mesh was being just eaten, sent through the line, and we had to take it and actually go blow it out, which we didn't have anything to blow it out, really. So me and Dan just sat there and just derped it up.
We had a tire chuck, you know, the little thing you put on your valve stems to air up the tires. Christian's holding it down using that, and then I've got what compressed air that you clean your keyboard out with.
Yeah, just almost none left. We're just blowing whatever we can.
Yeah. Luckily, I had a stainless steel filter instead of a paper one.
Yes. Yep.
So we got lucky.
Yeah.
And those are amazing.
But we got that issue worked out.
Got it worked out. Started driving the car again. Getting used to it because it is a whole new car to me again. And started shredding it again. And then we had some more problems where the wastegate fell off. So we had to find a bolt last minute from my cousin found a bolt. And we threaded it in, and it was not the right thread pitch, but it worked. It was the threads that were in there were metric, and we used just a standard bolt.
This was off of a tractor PTO.
Yeah.
And that he just happened to have on his truck. So we took it off, took the bolt out, threw it in. We realized we were cross-threading it. 2 threads into this thing. We're like, man, this is cross-threaded. We decided to send her home.
We didn't have another bolt.
Extra torques.
Yeah, we didn't have another bolt, so we just sent it all the way through.
For the sake of the event, we went for it.
It's fine. Most of the bolts don't fucking match on this car anyways.
But it worked. I mean, it held the 15 pounds that it was supposed to, and it didn't go over until the other bolt fell out of the wastegate. And then my downpipe fell off. I was wondering why my feet were getting so hot, and I was losing clutch pedal because the downpipe was off, so all the hot exhaust gas was going straight to my clutch line.
Now look at you or the camera.
You can look at the camera.
You look wherever you want. I usually look at y'all when y'all are talking, you know, to be respectful to you guys, and then I look back at the camera.
But then when I watch the video, you're just staring at someone forever.
Yeah.
Well, it's because they're talking.
I need you to look at the camera sometime to feel like you're talking to me. Like,
I'm talking to you guys.
We're talking to you, but I'm talking to him, but I want you to be involved with us.
Shut the fuck up.
Shut up, Meg.
Don't mind the voice in the back. Background voice.
But anyway, Stroud was fun. We had a good time. Our iPad turned off, so now we don't know what we're going to talk about. This is all
your
scripted.
Radiator. That's the next step.
Yeah, so my radiator. The night before Stroud, I decided to go out and decide if I can fix a hole in my radiator if I destroyed it. So what I did was got a drill bit, and I drilled straight through my radiator.
Got a background.
And we tried to TIG weld it, and it just burnt right through the 350Z radiator. because we used the 350Z as a test before we did that one.
Literally hours before event.
Literally. It was supposed to be an easy night of working on the car, and it turned into a shit show. So then we went to Walmart. It was the only place open, and got JB Weld putty and just crammed it into the fins in there, and then put some JB Weld epoxy over it, and it somehow is not leaking out the radiator, which we're lucky.
Got super lucky.
Yeah, I don't know how that.
And do you want to talk about how all the tuning went? Both days of tuning?
Both days of tuning? We only had one day. That's
right.
The two dyno days.
Yeah.
Well, if you guys haven't seen, you can watch the video. But the first dyno day went terrible. We were having fuel cut issues and we couldn't figure out why. And that is partially the fuel cell was partially why we were having fuel cut issues, I think. The foam degrading. But then we figured out that the software needed an update and they needed to change the trigger wheel. So then the second dyno day we had went more successful, but we had a blown head gasket in cylinder 3, we thought. And then when I pulled the head off, the piston number 3 was, it dropped a valve.
But it made it through all the tuning. It did all good all the way to the end. And then we were trying to problem shoot it and end up couldn't. And it was a bent valve. Luckily, we didn't trash the motor.
Yeah, luckily. If I didn't have forged pistons, those cast pistons would have split in half.
Oh, it'd have been epic. You guys would have enjoyed it.
would have had a fireworks show.
It would have been awesome.
Up next weekend. Well, I guess we say next weekend, April 7th. Okay, we say next weekend because we don't really know when this is going to be posted. But yeah. Next weekend from now, April 7th. Texas event, Mineral Wells,
it's an upshift event. It's not a Lone Star one. Upshift, the reason we're going upshift instead of Lone Star is because Lone Star is like $185 to drive, and I am not Pro-Am ready yet. And upshift is only $25 to drive, and they provide lunch to the drivers.
They feed you, yes.
Yeah.
So I've heard it's a higher speed track. Our friend Braden was entering at almost 90 miles an hour.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like a fourth gear entry, which is going to be pretty dope. We are going to turn the boost up for that event and see what happens. See if the car will eat or not. Maybe it'll blow up.
Send it. Is Brandon going to go down there with you?
No, we're going to data log it with my laptop that I just got.
Right on.
We're either going to data log it or I'm going to dyno the Friday before the event.
That's smart.
At his shop.
Just crank it up and disappear.
Yeah, it just depends on what the weather's like.
It's all fun until he comes back to the pits looking pissed.
Because I blew up my motor.
Something's wrong. And then we have to troubleshoot everything.
Did you guys see that huge white cloud behind me? It wasn't your tires, man.
It wasn't tire smoke.
His rings are looking weird. Do you think you can change them spark plugs and get her going again?
But for the Texas event, I'm going to be running some Kendas. I've never ran Kendas before. I'm going to be running their brand new Kenda street tires. Which will be pretty fun.
Are you going to burn off the rest of your Zestinos first?
I only have like 2 pairs left.
Oh, okay.
Jesus.
Went through them.
Yeah, we went through them pretty quick, actually. I didn't think we would go through all 12 that fast, but we
right,
did.
Right.
That's so awesome, though.
Yeah. So we're going to be running some new Kendos. We got a pretty good deal on them. They're only $78 a pop for us.
That's pretty damn
in
good.
In Oklahoma.
That's and you guys can find them at wherever the fuck he says.
Who can we get them through? Who can we find them?
Valicia on Facebook.
All right.
Really cool dude.
She's a girl.
Nuh-uh. Mm-hmm. No clue who this person is.
Alicia on Oklahoma Drift. On Oklahoma Drift, the Facebook page, you can find them. She sells them for a bunch of different sizes, but ours are $78 for their new street tire, which is actually a combination of their... So they took a mold of their grippiest tire they make, which has a lot of surface. But then they took the rubber compound of the tire that lasts the longest, and they put that compound in the mold of the grippy tire to combine this new street tire. And it looks like it's an insane, like, semi-slick-looking tire.
We're going to test it and see.
But we'll see. On the Zestinos, I had to run 15 PSI in the rear to feel good, so we'll probably run around the same 15 PSI. But then when the tire gets hot, it'll probably be around, like, 20-ish.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we'll run them at 15 cold and see what happens. Amateur, I swear.
Get out of here. Yeah, noob. What kind of track is this? Is it like a...
It's like a Stroud-type track. They have cones set up.
So it's going to be a big entry? Slab.
Yeah, it's just a big... I think it's supposed to be a big entry. That's how all their track layouts
are.
No, probably not.
God, perfect. If you guys seen the last event,
you can send it way harder.
Everybody was tearing up the wall.
Everybody fucked that wall up.
First event out, everyone was like, yeah, fuck this car.
Everyone was looking directly at the wall. The idea is when you're going towards the wall to try to drift as close as you can, look past the wall. If you look directly at the wall, you're going to hit it. You have to look past the wall.
It was sick. I was proud of everyone that drift tapped it.
Everyone nailed it. Some people totaled their car out.
Yes. It was ballsy moves. I was proud of all of you out there.
There's a Sil 80. Did you guys happen to see the Sil 80? It was a 240 hatch with a Sylvia front.
That it was stuck on?
Yes.
Man. I fucking seen it.
That car was clean, too.
He had a bash bar, thank God, I think, under his bumper. Or did it get stuck on his actual rail?
I don't know, man.
I guess what I seen, he was dragging it, and it was stuck on his rail. I was like, that is sick as shit.
I got fucked up pretty bad.
It's a drift car.
After the Texas event the following weekend, we've got
Mack Park.
Woo!
It's our most local park. It's our track. It's our easiest accessible track.
I'm going to be honest, I fucking hate it, though.
I know. We all do.
I hate that track, dude, but because it's so close.
I think both of our podcasts before, we were like, we're just not going to go to Mack Park. Yeah. But now it's like, Mack Park is coming, and we might as well just go. We might as well just be there.
They're doing the best entry contest, so we're going to try to... I'm going to try my hardest to try to do a 360. It'll probably never work out.
Jesus, you're going off into the back.
I'm going to try as hard as I can to throw
a Mack is a really small technical track. It's low speed. It's just really hard angle turns. I mean, it's super easy. It's like a little go-kart track that they test drive shafts at. It's a precision drive shaft is the shop right in front of it.
Yep. Which, I mean, they're better than I'm not going to say better. They're more lenient than OMC or...
Oh, I know it.
Or other events. Like, they don't even do tech inspections. Every time we have gone, they have never done a tech inspection on our cars whatsoever. They literally, as soon as you get there, you load your trailer off, and you literally get right on track. There's no tech inspection.
We don't need tech inspection.
They're super lenient about that.
I think not having tech inspection is why I get to drift.
Yeah, right? And you can do burnouts wherever you want, whereas OMC, you cannot do burnouts.
It keeps the grass roots grass.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
So we'll see how that event goes.
I feel bad for all them people who actually, like, if you watch anyone online go to an event and have to go through tech and everything, like, fuck that. We're not making that. We don't. Oh, God, they're so brutal in some places.
We've got a lot of friends that, like, want to try it out with whatever they have. Like, I've got a Miata or a 350Z or something like that, and they want to go drift, but they can't because they don't know if their car is, like, upgraded to tech inspection.
For the most part, if your car is bone stock, you can pass tech. But for competition now, you have to have fire extinguisher and a roll cage. But if you have a bone stock car with, like, a little turbo on it or whatever, then you can go. It's fine. As long as your seats are bolted in and you have working seat belts.
Yes. Very cool.
And your battery has to be tied down. That's literally the only rules they have.
You know what I seen that I'm super digging? Hmm. The Chop Top Challenge.
The Chop Top Challenge. Awesome. That was really cool.
That was the first time I've ever seen that. I didn't even know it was a thing until we were out there at the event. And I seen a bunch of people on the turnpike just rolling down in helmets. Super cool. And I was like, you guys are fucking legends. Yeah. So.
The guys that put on Grid Life.
Really?
Yeah, it's
people that put on Grid Life.
They drove from Chicago to Austin.
That's crazy. Yep.
And a homemade drop top.
The dudes are fucking nuts. I love it.
But yeah, we have Mack Park coming up. And then the day after Mack Park, there's another event in Texas.
Held that day too.
I'm thinking about going to that if I have enough money and tires to go to that one. It's literally the day after Mack Park. So
Load the car and just head down there and get a hotel.
Yeah, after the event. I'm thinking about it because I really would like to go to that track.
Party on.
But that track setup is a Club Loose, and Club Loose has a B, and C class, and you have to start out in the C class if it's your first time.
Yes.
And but I want to see, my goal is to try to make it to A class by the end of the day, which would be kind of cool, I think. A class is the tandems. C class is you're on the skid pad. You're not even on the track. All you get to do is figure eights.
Nice.
And then once you get done with the figure eights, they can move you up to B class if they think you're ready. And the B class is you're on track, but no tandems.
Where'd you say that was?
Club Loose in Texas. They do it at a couple of different tracks.
Have you told him about the deal I had? About the drift car?
I don't remember. What was the deal?
What you're doing right now. I didn't want to say it in this,
But to see if these guys might actually think it'd be a cool video.
Oh, that's right.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Would you want to mention it on here? Or is it something?
Let's go do it. Why not?
Why not?
Well, so Daniel is having fun with life, enjoying it, doing Postmates.
Oh, yes.
On the grind for the drift car.
I started some part-time Postmates.
Mm-hmm.
And it's super, it's cool. It's cool. It's just a new little thing to occupy my time. Tessa works late nights, so when I'm just sitting at home bored, this is something extra to do, and I get paid for it.
Yes.
So
he needs drift car parts. Please send them.
Right. Please send parts.
Send them P.O. Box 612 Minco 73059.
We
dual overhead cam, not single, please.
We're gonna, now that we bring it up, we're gonna try to talk Dakota into a Postmates in a drift car.
Yes.
And do some Postmates in his wild ass drift car.
And film.
That would be a pretty cool video.
Film awesome all video. Three of us. Full cage car. One in the backseat just doing the dumbest shit ever. Either Postmates is going to hate it or they're going to love it. It could be something that goes viral. I don't know.
I'm either going to get fired from this thing or they're going to really appreciate it.
Yeah, that would be cool. Their name out there.
Pretty cool video, I think. Yeah.
It'd be cool. It'd be super cool if they're like, you know what? Thanks for getting our name out there. That video blew up.
We'd have to contact them though to make sure that we could put their name on the side of our car or something for the video.
It'd oh no, cool. We're just gonna go be in the video. Who cares if we get copyrighted? Fuck them.
I would not like to get sued by Postmates.
Yeah, right, that'd suck. As long as we don't. I mean, Ostmates.
Ostmates.
Yeah, we're delivering for Ostmates.
Most pates.
Pater taters. But it rhymes with most mates.
We're just dropping off some Legos.
For Los Quates.
I think it would be a pretty cool video. It would
be pretty cool.
Yeah,
I've seen a video of some kids taking a 240 and doing pizza delivery.
Yeah.
So I think just a little more modern.
They didn't do anything wild, though. They just.
That's what I'm saying. We'd have to, like, burn out right in the driveway as soon as we drop the shit off. Like, your shit's here. They come out, sick-ass burnout. Here's your shit.
Right. A pretty hearty shred.
Thanks for breaking glass when my children play.
Well, what's up with the 350?
Yes. Not a lot. I mocked up the angle kit for it from FDF Fab.
Mm, beautiful.
That is super shiny and like baller looking. But I got to take it off because I just mocked it up. But I got to take it off to stitch weld the entire chassis of the car.
We need to.
That's a beefy kit, too. That you are not
right. You need to add photos. To this, so you know what I mean?
Photo bang, here.
Right there.
Photo there. There's going to be no photos. I'm just going to look retarded.
Right.
But yeah, I gotta take the kit back off. I just mocked it up. I didn't tighten anything down because I have to stitch weld the whole car, which is going to be a long and painful process.
You're ordering a lot of new parts, and you started some unboxing videos?
I did start some unboxing videos. Those will be on the channel soon.
What's in the box?
It's called What's in the Box.
I was going to tell you if you need to upload videos. I have fiber here, so you can upload.
I'm uploading some videos right now, actually.
Perfect.
That's why you want my Wi-Fi. You can plug straight in. I have the router plug in for my Xbox. No lag here. Fuck lag. Yeah.
But my Wi-Fi sucks, and I just got a new laptop, so videos will be coming very soon now.
Today, we are uploading all the videos he's had back-ordered for 6 years.
I don't know about all the videos. We'll do them a little at a time.
Well, we're going to upload them, but they're going to be private, and then we're just going to... So we don't have to sit there and upload them.
Yes, we'll upload them on private, and then we'll do it that way.
Yeah, because this video won't be released until next year.
Probably not.
But we love you guys.
We're trying.
We're trying. I mean, amazing guy.
I just thought about something about Mack Park, too.
What?
It's probably the quickest track to get around.
It is literally like 30 seconds and you're done.
It's the shortest track.
It is so short. Right. That's why I hate it.
You can drink and drive your car, but it's not recommended.
You can drink and
drive. Yeah, Mack Park, they suggest you don't, but there's no tech inspection again, so...
No rules, bitches.
You could literally get hammered and go in your car.
So we're too small of a channel for anyone to give a fuck anyways. Please don't notify Mack Park.
With it being a quick track, this could be the track that we can do the Carolina Reaper. Oh, yeah.
No, thank you.
We got to do this.
I'm down to ride passenger one person at a time. I'm down to ride passenger and film so when we crash, I get, like, your reaction of your car being totaled.
I think we should do, instead of Carolina Reaper, the one-chip challenge.
The one-chip?
The one-chip challenge.
We can do the one-chip.
Yes.
I'd be down.
That way, something...
Doesn't it hit the Carolina Reaper in a chip?
Yeah, but that way when I cough before I eat it, it doesn't go straight to the back of my throat.
I want to do something painful, you know, and it, like we'll
loser gets
it.
Paintball.
We'll cheers it, you know. Take we'll a bite.
Milk and ice chest waiting for us when we get off track.
You just kind of chuck soy sauce, whoever loses.
I would honestly rather be tasered while trying to drift than eat like a Carolina Reaper, honestly.
Loser has to get tasered.
I'd rather make a video of us trying to drift around a park while getting tased, like in the leg or in the arm.
I get to tase you.
I'd rather do that than a Carolina
Reaper. I roll around, film you, fucking zap.
Just zap us whenever.
On an entry, you're going for your handbrake. I zap the handbrake so you just fucking electrocute to it.
I think that would be a better video than Carolina Reaper.
I would love it.
Because Carolina Reaper, you could probably drift through the track. You're just dying the whole time. But getting tased, you're trying to like grab the handbrake and then you're scared to grab the handbrake.
I think the taser is going to keep you from driving. But with the chip, you're going to be crying and it's going to be hilarious.
I think with the chip, it's going to be bad too it's going to throw you off because you're going to be like.
But your reaction the whole time, if you've got a camera sitting on your dash pointing at your face,
yeah, but we have
people
a helmet
are
going
to die laughing.
We have a helmet on though. You're not going to be able to see your face.
That's true.
The thing, unless they allow us to run without a helmet.
Which, fuck that. I'm not knocking my head on any of y'all's cars and dying.
My roll cage sits pretty high.
It does. I hit my helmet on it.
Do you?
Daniel's helmet on it. Yeah, whenever we went out there, I put my foot up on your dash, and I was just dinking my head on the cage. I was like, it'd be cool if we had some of those Lomaxes.
Christian, you got any news for YouTube?
Yes. I don't own a drift car.
He doesn't own a drift car.
Right. Not yet. I'm waiting.
Soon, hopefully.
Soon, we hope.
Probably not.
He's just trying to get to me having a kid.
What? I'm trying to have a kid with you?
We've already had a child.
We've had a child?
Me and him. I'm going to be a dad. No, you fucking know me, so I can't really relay it to you like that. Because I always just film shit. Like, I work on shit, but mostly film. Or mostly work on shit and get filmed. I don't know. I just like to be in the background because this is different. It's fun.
Super different.
But I enjoy like filming them and being the dumb shit behind the scenes and getting them hyped for shots. Or just changing out the start of a BMW. 30 minutes. That's what I recommend.
No. I will never fucking buy another BMW.
Took me 2 hours. Fuck that. I tried to make a bet with Dakota. Took 2 hours. Just to remove. Piece of shit cars.
You know how Daniel wanted to do the one UZ swap? Guess where the starter is on the one UZ? Underneath the intake manifold. It's the
dumbest fucking shit ever.
Oh, Christian was there when Brandon talked me out of it.
He
was
like, I tried to talk him out of it before, and he would not listen until Brandon Carter, the man, the myth, the legend, talked him out of fucking doing it.
Yes. So, Daniel, how's your car since the season is back on?
All right.
And, Did you make it to the first drift event? Because you're probably just busting ass after first season, ready to go.
All right, so all winter long, I worked super hard on this car. I slaved away. I got a roll cage in it. I put body panels on it. I mean, I got a built motor, but then my head dropped.
I think you're thinking of Dakota's life.
That's my car.
Sorry, my bad. I forgot.
So what happened with your car?
In reality, after it broke... It didn't move.
It broke.
Months. It broke. And it broke. That's where it stayed.
And man, so we looked at the lower control arm today when we swapped it out.
It sheared.
It wasn't even the weld that broke. It literally just fucking like ripped the metal apart.
Cool. Man.
Jeez.
So my weld's not what broke.
What it wants you all to think.
This time. It started at the weld, but...
It wasn't the whole weld, so don't fucking count my weld.
It wasn't the whole weld, you know? It started shearing off on the metal.
We got the Villains LCAs on today. Yes. We got the D&D steering wheel secured down.
Which looks amazing.
It looks super nice, especially with the NRG seat. It makes it look way cleaner.
Yep, I had to use my holdfast wheel for the Z on the 240.
Thanks, man.
I'm so glad I got a wheel on there at least or something, because Daniel just sits like this anyways and drives.
And then we got the seat fixed. Yeah, we got the seat fixed and the
what'd y'all have to do to the brackets?
Literally nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
Literally nothing. We just moved them two holes and then used my... So you know how he was using the NRG seat brackets for the seat?
Yes.
They were fucking super long and tall. So
would you recommend them?
I would not recommend them at all.
They do not fit well.
They don't fit well.
Rock an NRG seat. I rock NRG seats. Do not use the C-rails for them. They're fucking garbage.
We used the planted seat brackets.
They're a lot lower, slim fitting. So if you're a taller guy, you'll fit in a car better.
Yep. It's perfect now.
And most already, of us are 5'6".
The holes were already drilled out when I used the brackets. So it fit perfect for Daniel. Now he's not like super far back in the seat.
Yes.
I'm just far enough back that if I want to kick the clutch all the way in, it's just my toes, full throttle, toes, perfect. Like, it's not like too far away where I have to sit super low in the seat, you know?
Yeah, it's a lot better now.
So, have you gotten any more parts, or what parts do you have right now for your car? Are you just, is this going to be another season in A, and then you're going to get turbo, or are we looking at motors?
Probably like half a season in
A. I think half a season would be in A.
Yeah.
Maybe a little more. Maybe three quarters.
What parts do you have right now?
We've got turbo, intercooler. We have injectors, but I don't know if I want to keep those. I mean, they're good enough to boost the car, but they're not good enough to what we want.
I wouldn't boost it. I mean, I wouldn't boost it with those injectors.
I don't want to boost anything.
You know? Cool.
I'm just saying we could if we wanted.
Single cam for life.
I mean, yeah, I don't want to have to be at the track and then that be the one thing that stops us and we can't fucking have a good day because now the injectors are clogged or some dumb shit.
I wouldn't use used injectors because you don't know what they've been
unless
through.
Unless you're going to send them to Deitch Works.
Yeah, right, unless you want to get them flow tested.
Everyone, it's called Deitch Works. Stop fucking up the name. It drives me insane seeing it on YouTube when people call it Deitch Works.
Do they really?
Deitch Works. Wow. Is what they call it. Yeah.
But do you ever comment on there?
Adam Elsie, you fuck it up, and it drives me insane.
But I wouldn't, even in those injectors, I wouldn't go get them flow tested there because they're stock SR injectors.
Mm-hmm.
I would get some like 550s. I would get some 550 cc's or
time to hit some of that eBay.
Yeah, I mean that's where I got my IDs from is eBay.
No, guys.
See, anyone tells
I'm
you
not gonna get
bad,
anything from
you.
eBay, okay?
Amazon.
I'm gonna get it from Amazon.
Amazon.
We're not broke, bitches.
Yeah, we're not broke around here. We can afford Amazon now.
Amazon Prime, you know, it'll ship it to you next day.
I'm broke as fuck.
Me too. I lost my phone, so
my phone got stolen right before this.
Right
podcast.
Before we started.
Like $900 gone now.
Oh my god.
Yeah. It's a brand new phone.
I thought it was old.
No, it's brand spanking new.
Jesus.
Yeah, my dad's gonna whoop my ass when I get home.
I didn't even get to fucking the other one because it was $1,000. What's that iPhone called? The stupid ones? The newer ones?
What are the newer ones?
The X.
Yeah, X. Team gender neutral X Force.
Oh my god.
No, fuck that.
How to get your video taken down from YouTube? Piss off the crybaby.
Well, I think that's all we got.
That's all we got right now.
There's an Eskimo hut. I wish they had sponsored us.
That would be an awesome sponsorship to have.
Alcohol snow cones.
Alcoholic snow cones.
Do you live in Louisiana? It's a normal thing to you. In Oklahoma, this is new to us.
Yes.
We just got it. Everywhere else in the world's pretty cool, except for when it comes to cars, because we have no fucking rules on the road.
We
drive the dumbest shit around here. So
we drive with open headers in Oklahoma.
Yes, so eat a dick every other state.
Especially California. You guys are getting fucked right now.
God, your state sucks so bad.
Wow, I feel bad. And they have all the cool cars too, which sucks.
Had
all the cool cars. They're
enjoy
all,
cats, pussies.
They're all reverted back to stock now.
Straight pipe for life.
Well, that's it for this video.
That's all we got.
Peace. Bye. Toodaloo, gay boys. Welcome to the